Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. We have now learned that the two people that died in their Nashua home were stabbed to death. Both are being treated as homicides. We're learning more about who the victims are. Autopsies have been completed on 83-year-old William Grant and his wife, Eleanor, who is 78 years old. The Attorney General's office is calling both deaths suspicious after discovering the bodies on Monday at their home on Newbury Street. Authorities have said that the public is not in any danger. And a developing story with a mom and her two kids taken to the hospital last night. An investigation is now open into what happened at this home on True Road. We know that last night about 7, officials responded to a medical emergency at 15 True Road. The woman that lives there, as well as her kids, ages 6 and 7, were brought to the hospital. And now all three are at Boston hospitals. We don't know their conditions or what happened, but the Rockingham County attorney is now involved. They say no arrests have been made. And we hope to learn more on this story for you this afternoon. A 52-year-old man who was tased for being disruptive at a rally in Concord yesterday is now out on bail. Investigators and witnesses say that Daniel Musso repeatedly interrupted a speaker at a rally for gun control, prompting police to move in and question him. He started struggling with the officers, who eventually pulled out their tasers. Because he made bail last night, his arraignment has been pushed back to August. And the Bruins, they're getting ready for game 4 of the Stanley Cup Finals in Boston tonight. This was the scene at TD Garden this morning as the Bees hit the ice for their morning skate. Ray Brewer caught up with some Bruins fans today.
At Modell's Sporting Goods, they're all ready for Game 4. There is everything Bruins that you could possibly want, from jerseys with your favorite player to sandals for the beach once the hockey season is over. The staff is also catching hockey fever, and it's spreading. To the Red Arrow, where Andrea Sullivan is proudly sporting her Bruins colors. A lifelong Bruins fan, she appreciates what Zdeno Chara brings to the ice.
What he gives to the team is awesome. I mean, he's definitely, you know, the one that he gives good hits, and when he does, it gets the fans going crazy, and, you know, it also makes it nice that most of the other teams really don't like going up against him.
Sullivan didn't want to give a prediction for the game, fearing she might jinx the Bruins. But Tyler Martin has no doubt, especially given the way that Tuukka Rask has been playing and the way the Bruins have been responding. He thinks tonight the Bees take a commanding 3-1 lead in the series.
They got the momentum, and they're really taking to the Blackhawks. So.
On Elm Street, Bob Fletcher was helping to put up a new sign. He's been following the team all season and says the Bruins look like a different team from earlier in the year.
It's going to be Bruins on top. And there were some disappointing games, but they have just, you know, when the playoffs started, they turned it up. They turned it up and just been pounding away. It's unbelievable to watch.
And even though Anita Johnson doesn't consider herself a hockey fan, she's still looking forward to celebrating the Bruins taking home the cup.
I was born and raised in Boston, so I would love for them to win. It would be huge. I'd still have a party just because they did, even if I don't watch them.
And the puck drops at 8 o'clock, and we will have coverage this evening. And also starting tonight at 5 o'clock, the Ohio man accused of kidnapping 3 women and holding them captive for a decade faces a judge. The possible plea deal to help him avoid the death penalty. Plus sidewalks exploding overseas. What could be triggering the blasts that have injured at least 5 people? That does it for us. Thanks for joining us, and have a great afternoon.